Welcome to the Roma Theatre Retrospective 2020, produced by the Independent Theater Hungary for the HowlRound Theatre Commons. Although Roma are the largest ethnic minority in Europe, they still experience high level of racism and have to deal with many societal issues. Additionally, Roma are being represented in a very stereotypical way in the media and art world. The Roma Theater has more than a century-long past with active professional theater groups in many European countries, but unfortunately, they are still hardly known. The Roma Heroes Theater Festival, initiated by the Independent Theater Hungary, is the only international Roma theater encounter in the world, which has been organized in every year since 2017. Some of the present artists and their work are introduced in our series. Today, my guest is František Balog, the writer and the performer of the play called The Roma from the Little Cat, or Enter the Majority, and David Popovic will be the translator. Hi, both of you.
Hello.
Okay, my first question would be simple. Could you please summarize very briefly what the play is about, how the idea came, what inspired you when you were writing it?
Okay.
Takže, mám preložím ti?
Najprv poviem a potom preložíš.
Okay.
Monodrama Romsperinky vznikla veľmi náhodne. Mojim blízkym som často rozprával svoje historky z detského domova, kde som vyrastal. Zdali sa im tie moje historky neuveriteľné a vždy mi vravívali, aby som si to písal. Tak som to nakoniec aj spravil a tak vznikla monodrama Romsperinky alebo Enter the Majority. Inscenácia je v podstate o motivácii. Sú to rôznorodé príbehy romského chlapca z prostredia detského domova až po jeho dospelosť. No a je to o akejsi integrity Roma do majority cez rôzne príbehy a stretnutia s ľuďmi, ktoré ovplyvnili jeho život, teda môj.
OK. The monodrama Rom from the Cat was created by accident. I often thought my loved ones, my friends or colleagues, my stories from the orphanage, from a children's house where I grew up. They seemed incredible to them. They always told me to write it down. So I finally did it. And that's how the monodrama Roma from the Cat or Enter the Majority was created. The production is about motivation. These are various stories of the Roma boy from the environment of an orphanage or children's house to his adulthood. It's about the integrity of the Roma into majority throughout the various stories and encounters with people who influenced his life.
And do you have a favorite part in the play because it is very close to you or because it was very challenging?
Moja obľúbená scéna je, keď odohrám svoje prvé stretnutie s matkou cez Skype. No a je to veľmi mrazivé, ale zároveň to má svoju iróniu a uštipačný humor. Divákov to vždy zamrazí, ale aj trošku pobaví. Je to veľmi katarzný moment, jak pre mňa, tak pre divákov.
My favorite scene is when I play my first meeting with my mother via Skype. It's very cold, but at the same time, it has its irony and teasing humor. It always freezes the audience, but also entertains them a bit. It's a catharsis moment for both me and the audience.
Thank you. My next question would be, who inspires you or who inspired or what motivated you during your life choosing your career?
David, prelož mi to.
Že, či je môžeš prosím povedať, že čo ťa motivovalo počas života, počas kariéry, vieš, tá tvoja riaditeľka, tak toto všetko v tom detskom domove.
Dobre. Od malička som vyrastal v detskom domove a naša riaditeľka Eva Jodlová bola a je aj dodnes nesmierne umeleckou dušou. Vždy nás viedla cestou umenia. Spievali sme, tancovali a podobne. Dávala nás na krúžky hudobné, divadelné, tanečné a podobne. Mňa to veľmi zaujalo a bavilo. Bol som dlho solistom súboru, ktorý na Slovensku aj v Čechách bol veľmi preslavený. No a to ma inšpirovalo stať sa umelcom a venovať sa umeniu aj profesionálne. Na javisku som stal v podstate od svojich 3 rokov a v podstate to ostalo mi až dodnes. V súčasnosti som členom štátneho divadla v Košiciach a považujem to v podstate za svoj vrchol. Som za to vďačný jak Bohu, tak aj svojej inšpirátorke Evičke Džudlovej, ktorá bola riaditeľkou detského domova až 52 rokov.
I grew up in an orphanage or children's house from an early age. Our director, Eva Jodlova, was and is an extremely artistic soul. She has always guided us and part of art. We sang, danced, etc. She put us on music and theater lessons. I was very interested and amused. I have long been a soloist of an ensemble that was famous in Slovakia and the Czech Republic. It inspired me to become an artist and devote myself to art professionally. I have been on stage since I was 3 years old and I still have it today. I'm currently a member of the State Theater in Košice and I consider it my peak. I'm also grateful to God for my inspiring Eva Jodlova, who was the director of the children's home for 52 years.
Thank you. And could you also please share a few sentences about your artwork? What is your art creed? What are your principles when you are creating art? And not just when you are creating art, but also when you are performing in your play.
David.
Takže vlastne, čo pre teba znamená romské divadlo, čo za to čo považuješ za nevyhnutné, aby romské divadelníci mali vlastne, či preferuješ, aby mali vlastné inštitúcie, alebo tak, nasledujúca otázka.
OK, takže som herec, takže na divadlo a na umenie sa pozerám väčšinou ako tvorivý umelec, ako herec. Hlavne, čo sa týka divadla. Neskôr som sa začal venovať aj réžii, nakoľko som zakladateľom svojho divadla, divadla Aktor Košice, a doposiaľ som vlastne hosťoval v rôznych divadlách ako herec na Slovensku aj v zahraničí. A samozrejme hosťoval som aj v rôznych filmoch v Rakúsku, v Čechách a na Slovensku. Občas som hosťoval aj v slovenských seriáloch. No a hlavnou a prioritnou prácou je moje samozrejme divadlo, herectvo a pedagogická činnosť v oblasti hereckej tvorby na umeleckých školách. V súčasnosti som aj umelecký pedagóg na umeleckej škole, čo je pre mňa veľmi vzácna činnosť, nakoľko a tu si uvedomujem, že neučím ja študentov, ale v podstate študenti mňa. A moje princípy umeleckej tvorby v divadle sú založené na 3 slovách. A to je sloboda, rozum a cit. A v hereckej tvorbe vždy presadzujem rozum, a teda logiku a zdravý pohľad na problematiku tvorivej činnosti. Rozum tvorivej umeleckej činnosti súvisí so slobodou. Herec pri tvorbe potrebuje slobodu v duši, aby mohol v podstate vypustiť prirodzený súzvuk citov, nálad, pohybu a zaujímavých hereckých prvkov. To považujem za veľmi dôležité v umeleckej tvorbe a umení.
I am an actor, so I look at the theater and art mostly as a creative artist. Especially when it comes to theater, so far I have performed in the various theaters as an actor in Slovakia and abroad. I have acted in the films in Austria, the Czech Republic, and Slovakia. Sometimes I also guest starred in a Slovak series. The main and the priority work is theater, acting, and the pedagogical activities in the field of acting at our schools. Currently, I am also a teacher of art education at an art school, which is a very rare activity for me. As I realize here that I do not teach students, but students teach me. My principles of artistic creation in a theater are based on three words: freedom, reason, and emotion. In acting, I always promote reason and therefore logic and a healthy view of the issue of creative activity. Reason in the creative arts is related to freedom. The actor needs freedom in the soul in order to release the natural harmony of feelings, moods, movement, and interesting acting elements. I consider it very important in the artistic creation and art.
Thank you. And what does Roma theater mean to you? Do you consider it necessary for Roma theater makers to have their own institutions, or what do you think about that?
David?
Čo pre teba znamená romské divadlo? Či si myslíš, že by sa malo viacej inštitúcií zakladať na Slovensku alebo tak?
Romské divadlo je pre mňa veľmi dôležitý prvok v kultúre. Je nesmierne dôležité pre rozvoj a tvorbu v kultúre, pretože je to súčasť nielen v tej ktorej krajine romské divadlo, ale zároveň súčasť svetovej kultúry. Je to veľké dedičstvo, ktoré máme možnosť prezentovať, rozvíjať. Je dôležité, aby vznikali romské inštitúcie pre kultúru, aby tak vznikol dialog medzi rôznymi kultúrami.
Roma theater is a very important element in the culture for me. It is extremely important for development and creation in a culture. It is part not only in the country of the Roma theater, but part of world culture. It is a great heritage that we have the opportunity to present, develop. It is important the Roma institutions for culture are set up in order to create a dialogue between different cultures.
Thank you. And my last question would be a simple one. What's your future plan, or what are your goals regarding your career and also your life?
David.
Takže aký je vlastne tvoj plán do budúcnosti? Aký cieľ sa týka tvojej kariéry alebo tak?
OK. Moje plány sú veľké. Budeme pripravovať novú monodramu, v ktorej budem hrať. Ide o autorský projekt, nazvali sme ho Monology diktátora. Ide o premenu Róma na niekoľko spôsobov. Mení sa podľa toho, aká je doba. Raz na Hitlera, potom na Charlieho Chaplina, neskôr na súčasného politika a potom na Róma seba samého. A on potom rieši v podstate súčasný stav politík, ľudí, kultúru a vzťahy medzi nimi. Potom ďalším projektom bude Helverová noc, je to psychologická dráma so štipkou humoru. Je to o dvoch hercov, jeden je Róm a druhá je opatrovateľka, čiže je to žena. A ide vlastne o psychicky narušeného chlapca, ktorý Róma, ktorý sa nechá zmiasť veľkou masou a tá masa sú vlastne fašisti a vtedy začne vlastne ten teror na jeho opatrovateľku, na seba samého. No, verím, že sa nám to všetko podarí a aj napriek súčasnej dobe covidu naše projekty úspešne rozbehneme.
My plans are big. We will be preparing a new monodrama in which I will play. This is an author's project. We called him The Monologue of the Dictator. It is about transforming the Roma into several ways. It changed according to the time. Once to Hitler, then to Charlie Chaplin, later to the current politician, and then to the Roma self. It basically addresses the current state of politics, people, culture, relations between them. Another project will be Helver's Night. It's a psychological drama with a touch of humor. It is about two actors. One is Roma and his babysitter. He's a mentally disturbed boy who gets caught up in a large mess of something like a fascists. And then the terror against his babysitter starts. I believe that we will be able to do all this, and despite the current COVID-19, we will launch our projects.
This sounds very interesting project. I'm really looking forward to seeing once them.
Že veľmi sa teší, že znie to zaujímavé, znie to zaujímavo, že dúfa, že sa to podarí.
Thank you very much.
And I really wish good luck for your plans and your goals in the future.
A želať vlastne veľa šťastia do budúcnosti.
Thank you very much.
But before we end up the discussion, I just wanna ask if there is something else you forgot to say, but you still want to mention because you think it's very important, then, you know, I just want to give you a space or time for that now.
Že vlastne máme čas, že vlastne keď si niečo zabudol povedať, tak to môžeš povedať a tak, že proste máme čas vlastne.
OK, môžeš len doplniť, že spolupracujem už aj s budapešťanským divadlom, medzinárodným divadlom od minulého roku a hral som tam u nich tú svoju monodrámu, divadle RS9.
Yes, I have a cooperation with the divadle theater in the Budapest. And I have in this theater my monodrama RS9.
Je to veľmi zaujímavá spolupráca a viem, že budeme naďalej dlho spolupracovať a spoločne urobíme zaujímavé projekty.
And this is very important and interesting cooperation with this theater.
A ešte môžem povedať, že v budúcom roku budem zakladať ďalšie divadlo. A bude to rómske divadlo. Bude sa volať Párno Kalo, čo je bielo-čierne divadlo, ktoré bude založené na tvorbu s rómskymi hercami a s rómskymi témami.
And next year, I will create my own theater, Roma theater for Roma actors, and
Párno Kalo.
And his name will be Párno Kalo.
A že sa bude zameriavať na rómsku problematiku.
And he will be. Have Roma problematics in his place.
Yes.
And it will be we can see it in Budapest or online, or what's the plan?
Že či to budeme môcť vidieť ako keby online alebo v Budapešti vlastne alebo tak. Tie hry alebo tak.
Už som s nimi komunikoval. Tak tiež sa zaujímajú o tú monodrámu, monológy diktatóra, ale už sme rozprávali aj o hosťovaní s Helverovou nocou.
Yes, I was communicating with this theater and he is interested in Helver's Night and
monológy diktatóra.
Monologue of Dictator.
Great. Okay, thank you. So then thank you for the discussion for both of you.
David? Ďakujem vlastne za diskusiu s nami obidvoma.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, and now you can see the performance called The Roma from the Little Cat or Enter the Majority, written and performed by František Balog. Enjoy the show.